which are called by my name. I'm going really slow so you can get it. Would humble themselves
and pray.
And pray.
Yes.
Biggest thing is for us to humble ourselves. Especially those of us of this color. We feel as though we have arrived. If nobody gonna tell me nothing, I ain't gotta take nothing. And if my people, which are called by my name, would humble themselves and pray. You don't understand that one way to stay connected to the vine and to keep the nutrients flowing is to pray. There's sometimes you got to turn the television off. You got to let your friends go out. You got to close the door to your room like I did today. Kneel down at that bed and snot and cry and tell God I'm sorry. Say, Lord, I've been a mess. Lord, I haven't done everything that you told me to do. But I got to get it together. And if you can only repent, there is hope for you. But as long as you say, I'm okay, I'm okay, I'm okay, I'm okay, you're not okay, you're not okay, you're not okay, you're not okay. And sometimes what it takes is a very humbling experience. And there's sometimes when the preacher is giving the altar call, and I'm standing there, I'm like, I need to run and lay across the altar. Because the altar is a place of sacrifice. And sometimes you've got to sacrifice yourself. You've got to lay on the altar and say, God, kill me again. And even when Paul said, I died daily. So daily, I got to come to you. Daily, I've got to come and say, Lord, you've got to destroy me again. And I don't mean literally, because he's going to give you another chance to get back up. But if you can only repent, there's a refreshing that's coming for you. But back to my preachers. And this is something that God gave me today. So I cannot be afraid. But if you are a preacher in this house, come to the altar. Come to the front. Wow. No preachers? Bishops, elders, missionaries, if you preach in your church, come to the altar. And how the scripture says, confessing your faults one to another. And I know there's some things that we don't want to say. Some things we don't want to express. But if we want everybody else to get it together, it's got to start with us. Amen. And what you're going to do, and I don't care if you make it high level or you make it detailed, but how the scripture says, confess ye one to another, confess ye one to another. Confess ye one to another. You can say it at high level, whatever, but I'm talking about that stuff that you know that's been tucked away. If you've been stingy, if you've been stiff-necked, if you've been hard on the people, but if you don't have any sin, don't say anything at all. But there's a problem right there. If you think that you don't have anything, that's wrong. Now the second half of the scripture says, pray ye one for another. So now what you got to do after they done said it out loud, after they confessed it, now pray for each other. Preachers pray. Preachers pray. Hallelujah. Thank you. after you prayed one for another, you confessed and prayed for one another that you can be healed. Now turn